Would you like a different way of recording billable expenses so that QuickBooks does not reduce your expenses at the moment you bill the client? Well, then you need to know how to record income from billable expenses. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. There are two ways that billing a client for job-related expenses could affect our account balances at the moment we bill the client. Placing them on an invoice may reduce the original expense, or placing the item on an invoice could instead be recorded as income. Now, you get to choose which way QuickBooks behaves. If you prefer to lower your expenses when you bill the client for billable expenses, then leave it the way it is. If you prefer instead to increase your income by the amount of billable expenses, then you can follow the procedure that I'm about to show you. You see, you would have to open the preferences window, which we will in a moment, by clicking Edit Preferences. Then you would have to choose the proper category of preferences, time and expenses. And then, of course, in the Company Preferences tab, you would have to click this box, Track Reimbursed Expenses as Income. And that's very simple, and we're going to do that in a moment, and the behavior of your file will change. Now, if we don't check the box and we leave it the way we've been doing, then at the moment we pay for a billable expense, of course cash is going down because we just paid. And as we learned in a prior video, the expense that you paid for goes up, just like you're paying a normal expense. And at the moment we bill, it will behave the way it behaved in the prior video. The expense goes down because the client is responsible for the expense, which means our expenses decrease because the client is now assuming responsibility for it when we place it on an invoice. And of course, if we bill the client, accounts receivable goes up by the amount that we billed the client. Now, if we do check the box, which is the way that we're learning it in this video, there is no difference at the moment we actually pay the expense. Cash goes down, and at the moment we pay the expense for our company, our law firm, goes up. Because at the moment we pay, QuickBooks does not yet know that we're going to bill the client. But at the moment we bill the client, instead of the expense going down, the income account goes up. And accounts receivable, of course, goes up by the amount we're billing for the billable expense. Now, please note, the net result on the profit and loss by client is still the same. Your bottom line of your net income is not going to change if you switch methods. However, the totals inside the categories of income and inside the categories of expense that are shown on your profit and loss will be different. It all depends on what works for you and your law firm. So when you prepare for this change, you have to consider the way we did it previously. The prior billable expense video did not check the box and simply decreased the expense at the moment we placed it on a client's invoice. After checking the box in the preferences window, you need to know that there is one additional step for each billable expense you intend to use. You must map the billable expense to the specific income account that will show on the profit and loss by client report. So here's the trial balance before the change. You can pause the video and double check your numbers to make sure that it's the same so that you can follow step by step. But let's take a look at this April 1 billable repair. When it was billed, it lowered the repair expense. Let's take a look. So if we go here to the trial balance, you know, you open your trial balance. If you look at repair expense and double click, you can see that for Betty, when we first wrote the check, it increased the balance of the account because it didn't know we were going to bill Betty. But at the moment that we billed Betty, she assumed responsibility for that expense. So the expense decreased and became zero. And of course, if it's on an invoice, it went into account receivable. And let's change the preference now. And by changing just the preference, let's see if anything changes. You'll see just changing the preference doesn't really affect the trial balance. Watch. We go Edit, Preferences. Now, of course, we're in the category, you scroll down to the category of Time and Expenses, click Company Preference, and this is the check mark that you want to check. Click here and leave the check mark, Track Reimbursed Expenses as Income. And notice by clicking OK for this preference, the numbers did not yet change. And the repair expense is still zero. The repair expense was still lowered by the bill because it was a prior transaction. However, let's also take a quick look at Betty's column in the profit and loss. If we go to the profit and loss by client, you can see that repair expense is zero and we have no income for Betty for repair expense. Okay, now, at the moment, April 1 was a billable repair, but at the moment we map our billable expenses, then you will see the change. We're going to map repair expense to a new account that we're going to create called Income from Billed Repairs. And what will happen when we change this? What will happen at the moment we map this income account to this change? Well, what will happen is that repair expense will come back because QuickBooks now knows that it should not take the money out of the expense. QuickBooks now knows that this income account is where to put the money at the moment you bill the client for a billable expense. And these will be the two numbers that will change at the moment that we map the repair expense to its corresponding income account. We do this, list chart of accounts, we go down to repair expense, and then we click account new, account edit, account edit. Now, we're editing this and notice after we click the preference, this little box appears at the bottom of every edit account window that is in a category of expense. And we're going to create an income account at this moment. Notice QuickBooks knows it's an income account. Income from billable repairs. That's all you have to do and save and close. Now we save the edited account and now when we open the trial balance, aha! Look what happened. Repair expense came back to 200 and income from billable repairs showed up for the first time as 200 because the preference was changed at the moment we mapped the item. So it will retroactively change anything that you did before. Now, if we take a look at the profit and loss by client, you'll notice that only Betty has 200 income. We have 200 income from repairs from Betty, and we also have 200 in repair expense. We have both instead of neither. See? 200 here and 200 here. We have both instead of neither because we are now tracking billable expenses as income. Now, let's map our other billable expense. We didn't do this yet, so it's important to see it how it would look if it were changed from the beginning. So let's change research expense to income from billed research And then we'll do an example. So let's go ahead and do this. List chart of accounts, account new. It's an income account. Oh, excuse me, we won't do it that way. We will instead go to research expense and then edit the account so that we can click this check mark. This way we know that when we scroll up and add new account, it's an income account. Income from billable research. And you can add the account on the fly by clicking Save and Close. And now we're connecting it to this account by clicking Save and Close for the edit. Now, of course, the trial balance won't change because we didn't record any research expense transaction. But for example, let's imagine on May 15th, we paid the research guy $1,400 for a job related to Candy Charles, the client. And we'll bill Candy later for this. Now, when we pay for the research on May 15th, what will happen? Cash in bank will go down, and it will become $11,500, and the expense will go up, and it will become $2,000. Okay, because we already have $400 in research. So we take a look. See, research expense, we already have $600, but it wasn't billable. You see, it was tracked to a client, but it wasn't billable. But now, look what happens when we just pay. When we pay, we write a check, and it will be May 15th of, I think our little story is 2017. Okay, and it comes out of the cash and bank account, got to be careful. And we're paying a research guy, so you can just put research guy. Okay, and the account that it goes into at the moment we pay is research expense for $1,400. And we know this relates to Candy and that it's billable. So we're going to click Save and Close, and notice the trial balance is exactly as what we expected. Cash decreased to the number that we knew it would, $11,850, and research expense, $2,000. Double click, you see they all went directly into research expense. Let's also observe the profit and loss by client. If we look at the profit and loss by client under Candy, we see that for Candy, there's $1,800 in research expense because $200 prior research expense was for Alan. And if we double click this, we see just for Candy, there were two checks prior for research expense. So the numbers are what we need them to be going into the next section. Now let's continue in the example. And let's imagine that we're billing Candy for $3,000 in legal fees. And we are including the May 15th research. So when we bill the client, what happens? The accounts receivable goes up because the client owes us more. And the income account, income from research, billable research, of course, will go up because we get income from billable expenses. But the expense itself will not change. Now that we change the preference, research expense will not change. Instead, the related income account will go up. So what will change in the trial balance at the moment we bill for this research? Well, there's no change to the research expense account. The research expense account this time will stay the same, even though we're billing for it. Instead of changing, what we will see is income from billable research show up for the first time as $1,400. And of course, because there are $3,000 of legal fees on this invoice, income from legal fees will increase by $3,000 and become $24,946. We open the invoice window and make the date May 21. The client is Candy, and of course we select the outstanding expense. We click expense, choose the billable expense, and click OK. Now of course we add our normal fee for our normal service, legal services rendered, $3,000. And now in the bottom left, when we click save and close, oop, and of course don't forget about that option, we can open the trial balance and see the results are exactly as what we expected. The research expense did not change. The income from billable research showed up for the first time as $1,400. And of course, unearned legal fees decreased and became a positive number and shouldn't really be called unearned legal fees because now it's receivable to us. And the most important thing to check is the profit and loss by client. You can see in the column of Candy, we now have income from billed research while still having the research expense.